Anita Bursey with Ford. We're going to talk about the 3-liter new power stroke engine. And so what's your title at Ford?
I am the 3-liter engine system supervisor.
Okay, and what does that mean?
It means that I make sure the engine comes together. We have a lot of component engineers working on the engine, but we have to make sure everything's coming together, that the engine is delivering its attributes of power and torque and durability.
Okay.
And then we work with the vehicle team to integrate it into the vehicle. So working with the other powertrain groups, including powertrain cooling, exhaust system, transmission, to make sure everything is bolting up, integrating, functioning. And then finally, I interface with our vehicle plant who has to build this into the truck. So we do a lot of our assembly. We have what's called the engine is shipped, and that's what arrives at our vehicle plant. And then we have a few bits and pieces that get put on at the vehicle plant that we also have design responsibility for. So we have to make sure everything is being assembled properly. One of the subsystems that we specifically designed for the F-150 is our turbo subsystem and the exhaust. We have a single turbo, so we join the flow from both the left bank and the right bank. They come together. There's a crossover piece that goes across the engine, and the exhaust flow joins at this large single turbo. This is a ball bearing turbo that's for fuel efficiency, also less friction. It can spin up quickly.
Good.
And we also have variable vane control. So this is an electronic controller. You can see that there's a shaft here, and that will control the angle of the vanes and how much boost you're actually producing.
Okay.
So you open the vanes and you produce less boost. You close the vanes down when you want the most boost. So that's something that our calibrators are able to adjust depending on how you're using the engine. Okay, our 6.7 liter engine also uses variable vane control.
Okay.
So that's a similarity between the two engines.
All right.
Big deal with diesel is the fuel system. So we have a common rail system. Our components are primarily Bosch in our engine, so our fuel rails, our injectors, and our high-pressure fuel pump are all with Bosch. Very similar pump and injectors to our 6.7 liter.
Okay.
Additionally, our powertrain control module that controls the engine is a Bosch controller, and it's the same architecture as we use with the 6.7 liter. Same architecture, similar strategy. So our calibrators who calibrate the 6.7, that work translates very well over to our 3-liter.
Okay.
And we've had folks who've worked on both. So we think we have a really good understanding of that strategy and how best to optimize it. So that's something else we share with the 6.7. CGI block, the technology behind that compacted graphite iron.
Right.
That's another thing we share with our 6.7 liter. We think that's the most durable, best material to use for our blocks.
Okay.
Yeah, those are some of the major similarities, I'd say. Obviously, it's a much smaller engine than the 6.7, which is more than twice the displacement. But this is a V6. That's a V8. A little bit of architecture differences. We have exhaust outboard on the 3-liter, whereas on the 6.7, it is inboard exhaust, and they mount their turbo in the valley. This is much more similar to the layout of the gas engines that are in the F-150, which are all exhaust outboard as well.
Gotcha. You have a 6.7 liter, don't they call it the Scorpion?
Scorpion is the internal name, yes. That's the name that we've given that one, is the Scorpion, yes.
You know, the 6.7 is a fairly proven engine.
Yes.
And so, being this is new, it would be good to know from a buyer's perspective that you know, this will be as durable as a 6.7 liter.
This engine has gone through the full gamut of the Ford tests, our bottom end durability tests, our start-stop tests. It is fully proven out for the design life of this engine. The design life of this engine is 150,000 miles.
Yeah.
One thing unique about this engine in the F-150 is a slightly different warranty, where our powertrain warranty is 5 years 60,000 miles.
Yep.
The engine specifically, being a power stroke, is 5 years, 100,000 miles.
Oh, nice. Okay. So tell me then, what else have we got going on that's unique or new or that you had to do to get this into the F-150?
Okay. So to get into the F-150, we had to think about air induction, for example. Air is pulled from the air box, comes to the turbocharger, gets compressed. That compressed air will go back forward to the charge air cooler so we can cool off that compressed air.
Right.
And then our cooled charge air comes back in the engine. It comes from the front left. So you'll see we have this manifold, our intake manifold,
yep.
has a nice gradual turn to point this way to have a nice smooth entry from the charge air cooler.
Okay.
You don't want to be making very quick, fast turns, right? That builds up your induction losses. So having the nice gentle turn is good. We also have our Egr system. We introduce our exhaust gas very close behind the throttle plate. What happens then is that exhaust gas gets good mixing prior to the split to each bank, which means good distribution bank to bank of the Egr.
Okay.
So that this is a unique, specific part to our F-150, this manifold itself.
Gotcha.
Our accessory drive is also unique to the F-150. In the F-150, they have the air conditioning, the AC compressor is on the right-hand side of the engine. All of the lines to the system want to be on that side. Our alternators are on the left-hand side. So to make that accessory arrangement work, we went with a dual shiv. So there are two accessory drive belts on this.
Okay.
The shiv that drives the AC also drives our mechanical fan. So this engine uses a mechanical fan. The alternator and the water pump share a shiv. We made a decision on this vehicle to do was to do a mechanical fan with an electronic controlled clutch. We can freewheel the fan when we don't need to be pulling power, but that mechanical fan really has a lot of pulling power. So when we're really under load, long time sustained load on grades, we're able to hold our water temperatures and not have to derate or pull back power in the engine to get up that hill. And really when this truck is working, that cooling capacity really helps us to keep it working. Another thing to highlight about our engine is our diecast structural oil pan. So it's important to maximize our sump volume. We want to get as much oil in as we can.
Yep.
The more oil, it helps with that quality of the oil, really helps you to meet your oil targets, which is 10,000 mile oil changes for this vehicle.
Oh, okay.
We do it with this diecast pan. And one of the things we were able to do with our diecast pan is we actually are pulling it from two different directions. You see there's a cap on the bottom?
Yeah.
Instead of coming to a solid cast bottom and drafting upwards, we would have lost a lot of volume at the bottom with that draft angle. So this design actually pulls from the top and the bottom. And when they do that, they can draft outward. We can make more use of this bottom area and then just cap it with this. So by doing this as a die cast piece with that two pull in this opening, we're able to get best volume. With start stop application on this, we have a very large starter. Right, to really handle the number of times you're starting and stopping the engine. And so that was something, you'll see there's a bit of area taken away from the pan to allow for that large starter.
Right.
So, we had to get creative on how to get the volume, knowing we had these constraints of the large starter. And we were able to do that. Additionally, being a structural pan, we have a very nice, we're able to get a real good joint with our transmission housing. You'll see not only do we have nice structure on the top, but we're able to carry structure through the bottom here, which means for very good powertrain bending. Good powertrain bending means better NVH characteristics. Yeah, noise and vibration are, make a lot of sense. The harshness is more of the nebulous one. Some people ask a little bit about noise and what do we do relative to noise. Injectors are an area that we concentrate on. Not only can we handle noise with how we calibrate those and the injections, but we do try to encapsulate that. We have a sort of a foam under, and then it gets capped with an over. So we're encapsulating this area to keep that noise from coming out of this area. We also, around our fuel pump, the high-pressure fuel pump, we have another foam cover that's able to encapsulate this and help really prevent any noises from coming outside of that engine compartment. Yeah, we're very pleased with the sound of this engine. We think that the team did a great job optimizing it.
Well, thanks for your time, Anita.
Thank you very much.